Scene 22. Hey y'all, artist poet girl here, also known as APG Jamie, and today we're going to play with some flowers, and then later on we're going to play with some buttons, and that's Champ. That helicopter noise you hear in the background is Champ shaking his head, making his ears go helicopter, helicopter. So I'm going to use the flower petals to make a dragonfly. And y'all saw how I took apart the flower. And now I'm going to trim the petals, keeping two together. And I'm going in at a wedge. So then we have little wedges. And those two will be glued together. I'm going to adjust my mic. It feels windy in here. It could be my fan. Oh. So I'm putting on my favorite glue and just putting it on a little point there, and then I'm going to stick one point to the other point so that we have two petals that are mirror images, mostly, sort of. I'm going to trim that point off just a little bit because it was just a little too pointy, and I thought, no, we're going to just round that just a little bitty bit. So I did. And that's okay. You wouldn't be able to see it in the end out anyway, so. But still, I wanted to. Now, I decided I was going to try 9. So, I'm counting down the 9 faux gem ribbon stuff from the Dollar Tree, y'all. So, that's what I'm doing. And I'm trimming off because these have, it's a self-adhesive back. And they are attached to each other by way of a thread that is the same color as the faux gem. In this case, red. And I've trimmed those little tiny threads as close as I could get them anyway. And I have this sliver of a piece of yellow cardstock. I'm going to remove the adhesive backing from the faux gem, and I'm going to lay one side of the gems on the cardstock and then fold it over, and I will have a quick little redo of this particular part so you can see it closer. Hopefully this should work out. I believe it will. So I'm using my binder clips to smoosh that all together so that it'll be happily married with my favorite glue. And I'm going to punch out some little holes with just a regular size hole punch. And I'm going to get these little dots. And I'm going to glue two of them together. And then I thought later on, after I'd glued three of them together, I thought, well, I'm going to glue one on one side of the little piece of yellow cardstock and one on the other side. And don't worry, you're going to figure that out and see what I'm talking about in a minute. Because I'm trimming that off. And I'm leaving just a little bit of yellow there. Because this red thing here is going to be, you know, the red hole is, or the hole filling the hole. Anyway. It's going to be the head of my dragonfly. I'm going to put some glues on there. There it is. There. Okay, so we got one red on one side and one red on the other side of our little slivered cardstock. And I'm going to trim that off because we don't need it. Gosh, it's windy in here, y'all. Oh, I'm telling you, you'd think it was spring or something. So, there we go. Trimming the paper as close, or well, it's not really paper, it's cardstock, whatever, same difference. Trim it as close as I can to those faux gems, okay, because I do want this kind of looking nice. All right, y'all. Now, and I was inspired by, oh my gosh, now I have to remember her name. Let me see. Oh, I'm putting little black dots on there for our eyes, y'all. I was inspired by Al John, Amy, okay, link in the description box below, and I will try to get a link in the iCards upper right hand corner. You can see me pointing to the upper right hand corner. That was just a Higgins brush marker I used to put the black spots on that red gem for the eyes. Because it glued a red gem on there if you weren't watching. Now, these ends of these petals are kind of divoted, you know, and I'm just taking one of the divots off and just kind of rounding it over. Dragonfly wings can more or less be the same length. Don't fret about it too much because these are faux dragonflies, y'all. These are fantasies, okay? And you can make them any stinking color you want. I just happen to like these little red and yellow flowers that I had. And, you know, it's that kind of time of year and, you know, all that stuff. Because this is for the hashtag 12 paperclips of 2018, which is a Facebook group. Link in the box below. Oh, along with the list of ingredients, y'all. So now I'm gluing my two wings onto a piece of red cardstock because I'm going to add, this month for November is favorite season. Okay. So I'm just going to use that paper clip right there and slide it on down. It's going to hold the wings in place. Just wait any day. And it's a hidden paper clip, y'all. Y'all know I like them hidden ones. Hidden. So, what are we going to do now? Just piddle with it. Piddle with it. It's even. It really doesn't matter if it's that even. It's even enough, y'all. So, if you try this at home, try to work out the numbers of your, am I gluing my gem on now? Oh, I thought I glued my gem on there already, but I didn't. Must have been going around that red dot with the black pen. Sorry. Okay, so now we're putting on the actual gem, which is the head of the dragonfly. And I'm putting a red gem on one side and a yellow diamond on the other. Real faux diamond, y'all. And then we're going to put my favorite glues down the length of those. Oh, now we're going to put the eye on the red side. We're going to put, good gracious, why does it take so long for the stuff to come out of my mouth, get transferred from my head to my mouth? I don't know, y'all. I just don't even know. I know, how confused. I try to do a process visio. For heaven's sake. I try to do a process video with a little bit of tutorialism in it, and there you go. So there, I put my favorite glue down the length of my dragonfly body. Okay, save, you know, the last two little faux gems there. And that is actually gonna wiggle right in between the metal part of that jumbo paper clip. I couldn't have measured that out more precisely if I had tried, y'all. Serendipity. I love it when that happens. Just love it. So there we are. And it's dried it up. And now I'm going to put my banners on there, my little taggage, because it's favorite season. And my favorite season is dragonfly season. Dragonfly. Not flies. Not fly season, y'all. Dragonfly season. Because dragonflies don't buzz around my head yet. So I'm going to show you how I do that little banner tail, fish tail thingamaflotchy there. So you trim it up about as much as you want it short. And then you just kind of go one little line, mostly in the middle, as middle-ish as you can get. And then you go from the corner to the middle. And from the corner to the middle. And there you go. There's the dragonfly season. Now on the other side, I'm going to put summer because that's my favorite season. All right? Especially if I'm in the air conditioning looking out at summer through a big plate glass window. I love my air conditioning, y'all. So there we go. Now I'm going to show you that part where we're going to fold over the gems. Now I think I might have sped it up. And I might not have, because, you know, we just never know what I'm going to do. Oh, I did. I sped it up 1.5 times. So it's semi faster. So put my glue on. I'm taking the release paper off the back of the faux gems. You don't want to miss the buttons coming at, y'all. I don't know what time they come up, but it won't be real long. Just hang in there. Or you can, you know, zip forward and find the buttons. You don't want to miss the buttons. Just saying. Because I loves them. I loves them the first time I saw them, and I loves them the second time I saw them, and I had already known by the first time I wanted to do them. Did y'all see how I folded that over? That adds just a little bit more body to the dragonfly body, as well as putting a little bit of color in between the faux gems, okay? Because like I said, those faux gems, they're like little plastic dots that are all attached on a red thread, okay? Mm-hmm. But seriously, that's what it is. So I'm just kind of trimming that up just a little bit. And we're going to set that dry, and then I'm going to go ahead and do my red dots and the red gem on top and put the little painty eyes on the red gem. You know, because it needs some eyeballs on there, y'all. It does. It's dragonflies. And you know, dragonflies, they don't really have antennae. They do technically have antennae, but they are like way shorter and smaller than their head, and you got to do a really super close-up zoom to even see them. So, because they're not pollinators. They don't pollinate flowers and vegetables and plants and nuts and all that silliness. They're meat eaters. They're carnivores, okay? So they don't have a huge need for the antennae. So don't worry about putting those antennae on your dragonflies. Unless you just truly want them, because in that case you can, because it's a fantasy dragonflies after all. Just saying. So there, that's that one. I'm just going to set it aside. And, I'm going to show you how to cut another one of them little fishtail things. So you just trim it about the way length you want it, about straight, and then you go one snippet up, and then from the corner to the snippet, and then from the other corner to the snippet again, and now you got fishtail. See, look at that. Ta-da! I did not invent that. Okay. I learned it from my prior YouTubers. So now we're going to play with buttons. Now, instead of y'all watching me sort these buttons out by color, because next month is December, and it's going to be, what's the theme for December? See, now I don't remember the theme for December. Let me pull that at. Oh, buttons. Bless my heart, y'all. The theme for December is to use at least one button. And because it was December, I was picking out my white ones, my red ones, and my green ones. Okay, I don't have any silver, and I guess I could have went gold, but I didn't. I had a bunch of white ones, and I was able to get them sorted out so I'd have enough to make more than one button tassel. Okay? Okay. Now, I'm going to try to put this other link up there, and it's going to be to Bootsy Sweet Tarts. Okay, his name is Roy over there, and I first saw him do these button tassels a while back, not a whole long time while back, but just a little while back. And I thought, I love them. I have got to use that for my upcoming button month for my hashtag 12 paperclips of 2018 challenge. Well, it's not really a challenge, it's a swap thing. So, any hoodles, I saw that and I said, yes, I'm going to use that. And then, would you believe, about 2-3 weeks after I first saw that, I saw Roy over there on Stacy's channel, Pink Poodle Crafters. Okay. Also, link in the description box below, and I'll do my best to get one up in the right hand corner, because she was his special guest one time and he was making his button tassels on there. And I thought, that is just makes me want to make them even more. That's what it did. Now, I'm not going to necessarily tell you how I'm doing them. You can see how I'm doing them. But if you really want to know the lowdown on these button tassels, y'all need to go over there to Bootsy Sweet Tarts, okay, and watch him and check him out, because he's a fun guy. Just saying, he's a fun guy. And everybody knows Pink Poodle Crafter, so Double up on that. See in both places. Okay? Okay. So, there I am. I got my little button and my little... I used eyelash trim. He's been using... well, yeah, he might have been using crochet thread, too, because I use crochet thread a lot, which is what I'm running through there right now to tie all my loops together. And I tie my loops together with crochet cotton thread. I know, it's just a repeat, and a repeat. And then I'm going to wrap them around just another piece around just a little bit to put just like a, just a little bit of regular tassel end on there. Okay. And then I'm going to make a loop to the loop. I'm going to tie it around. I'm going to put my paper clip through there. And they're so stinking cute. I just love these button tassels, y'all. Thanks so much, Roy. Genius. I know I left comment on your blog, on your video saying so, but truly, genius. And y'all need to go over there and check him out so y'all can see, you know, how he uses his button tassels. Because, yeah, baby. And I'm going to trim that off so that it's just all kind of more or less mostly the same. Doesn't have to be perfect because, you know, Lord knows I'm not. And I think I put a little drops of glue on there in a couple places. These are so stinking cute. They might not look much on the screen, but I'm telling you, they're stinking cute. They don't stink, though. They just cute. So I'm making a knot. Kind of a sleep knot. Oh, that was a magic word, wasn't it? Okay, so I made a slip knot, and now I'm going to put any day now. I know you're all thinking just any day now. APG, come on, any day. So I'm gonna put the paper clip through there, and I'm gonna roll it around. And I'm gonna put a drop of glue on the little knot. You know, make sure it's pretty squared up in there. You don't necessarily need the knot. If you really wanted to, you could use a jump ring, okay? I didn't want to. So y'all know I was having them hand problems from making all that jewelry and stuff earlier a month or so ago. Oh, Lord, that hurt so bad. So I'm trying not to use my hand that way. So I'm going to trim off that. It's so cute. Makes me happy. Is that knot tied? Is it good and tight? Oh, dude, let's just put one more knot in there just for grins. Now, these are buttons, y'all. Don't let your children's or your grandchildren's play with these because they're buttons and they can choke to death on it. Don't let that happen. Okay? These are for grown-up people journals. See, look what? Look at that. I just love it. Oh, my goodness, y'all. And we are just about to conclude this year's hashtag 12 paperclips of 2018 in the Facebook group. Be sure to click over there and join up if you want to partake in swap next year. I think there's a swap next year, 2019. I'm hoping so because it's been kind of fun for me. Can you see the little black spots for the eyes? I did a little like, look at the buttons, y'all. Loves it. Makes me happy. I appreciate each and every one of you, your valuable time, your kind comments, your likes, your shares, your subscriptions. And if you haven't done so, please subscribe and click on that little bell so you get notifications of my new videos every Friday, 9 a.m. Central Time. Thanks for watching and happy arting, y'all.